Suto sapungsam suchira samasya nanja sasurirvirtartho tattad gunanu sabanam mukunda padar vinda hideish yesham. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Gauriya Goshtipati told that Bhagavad Kipa you cannot get directly. There is some procedure, there is some channel. Tat Shakti, Tat Prakash. Through this channel you can get Bhagavad Bhakti, not directly. It is not possible for bonded soul to get Bhagavad Kipa directly. You can get through Guru Vaishnava, Tat Prakash, Tat Shakti. Through this channel you can get properly, not directly. Actually, you can remember one slok from Padma Puran. Sampradaya vihinaje mantraha asti nisphala mataha. Of course you have heard, I think so. Sampradaya vihinaje mantraha te nisphala mataha. Without authentic sampradaya, if you are going to take mantra, if you are going to do bhajan without proper channel, be sure that you are not going to come out successful. You cannot come out successful. You will have to go through proper channel. That is the procedure. But first of all, I like to clarify the sloka. First of all, I like to clarify the sloka I started with. What is that so? I told you, sutasya pungsam suchira samasya nanjo sasari virita artha tattat gunanu sabanam mukunda padar vinda hidayishu jesham. Actually, it is from Bhagavatam. Very nice sloka. It is written there. Actually, if you like to put so much energy to recite Ved, Vedanta, everything, you are giving so much energy. You can do. You are at liberty to put your energy there. No problem. We have no objection. But be sure, if you get so much time, because your life is very limited, you are going to put all your energy to learn Ved, Vedanta, everything. And I know myself, so many, you know, people going to learn Vyakaran in 15 years, 14 years, they cannot learn Vyakaran properly. They cannot understand. They cannot write Sanskrit. This way, actually, it is an excellent advice by Bhagavatam. Srimad Bhagavatam going to give us nice advice. What? Jasuto sapungsam suchira samasya nanjo sasuri viritartha tattat gunanu sabanam mukunda padar vinda hideishu yesham. What is your ultimate goal? What is your ultimate goal? To achieve the lotus feet of Supreme Lord? To get nitya seva? Then why you are going to waste your energy running here and there like foolish? Advice you don't know? It is written there. What? Well, you will have to serve such a sadhu, such an elevated Vaishnava, inside whose his heart Krishna is there. You will have to serve that kind of sadhu who already keep Krishna inside heart and lock the door. Krishna cannot go out. See, it's very good for you if you can serve that kind of sadhu, so you can fulfill your desire. Very shortly you can come out successful by the service of a pure devotee, say Guru Vaishnava. So why you are going to take trouble? This is the sloka meaning. I can explain more, but today's topic is very high topics. I will have to discuss so many things. I cannot see the end like ocean. So anyway, sampradaya vihinaje mantraha te nisphala mataha. This is a sloka. Is there from Padma Purana? It is advised there that without any authentic sampada. What do you mean by authentic sampada? You already know. You don't know authentic sampada. There are only four authentic. I can discuss tomorrow also. Four authentic sampraday. Authentic means approved by Supreme Lord. Authentic means approved by Supreme Lord. Four authentic sampraday you can find. One is Madhva Sampraday, Sri Sampraday, Vishnu Swami, or Sri Sampraday. Actually, Nimbarka Sampraday, Vishnu Swami Sampraday, Nimbarka Sampraday, Sri Sampraday, I mean Ramanuja Sampraday and Madhavacharya Sampraday. You should have a clear conception about this. I have no time to go in detail. Deep philosophy, someday if time permit I can do, but basic conception you should have that this Madhva Sampradaya coming from Brahma. Madhva Sampradaya is coming from Brahma. Is coming from Brahma, Madhva Sampradaya. And Sri Sampradaya actually coming from Lakshmi Devi, Sri. Follow? And actually Vishnu Swami Sampradaya coming from Rudra. And Nimbarka Sampradaya, they are coming, have their hereditary factor, I mean lineage, with Chatusham, Chaturkuma. This is the basic thing. Now actually, we'll have to go into deep philosophy. Actually, Prabhupada told that Bhaktivinoda Thakur already declared this point in front of us. Be careful, don't forget this. Bhaktivinoda Thakur what told? Prabhupada giving us reminder. Actually, you should remember this point, that those who are not going to confess that we belong to Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya, they are the topmost spy of Kali. They are the topmost spy of Kali. Bhaktivinoda Thakur repeatedly told, Prabhupada's giving reminder, those who are not going to confess that we belong to Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya, those who are not going to confess, be sure they are topmost spy of Kali. Because it is the arrangement of Kali. It is the arrangement of Kali. It is the arrangement of Kali. In every family, their members, they are fighting. In mortal sadhu, fighting with each other. In all society, everywhere fighting going on. There is no solution. It is the arrangement of Kali. But Kali cannot do any harm to you if you are going to do exact bhajan. Follow? Many people putting question before me, Maharaj, why Parikshit Maharaj, the great king, not killing Kali, escape him? Better if he could kill him, no problem. But it is, answer is there, Parikshit Maharaj is a Saranga Eva Sarabhuk. About Parikshit Maharaj, it is written in Bhagavatam that Parikshit Maharaj is just, why, how, what? The Saranga Eva Sarabhuk. Saranga mean? Saranga mean? Brahmar. Brahmar mean those going to honeybees. Saranga Eva Sarabhuk. He is going to, because you know, in flower, there is honey. Everybody know. But in bisho, in honey, in flower, poison is also there. Nobody knows. In flower, you can get honey. But you don't know, in flower, there is some sort of poison also there. But that poison cannot disturb the collection of honey. Honeybees always very freely collecting honey from flowers without any disturbance. Eh? So this way actually Parikshit Maharaj is compared with the honeybees. So pure, he can see past and future very nicely. Parikshit Maharaj could realize that this Kali is dangerous, I know. Kali is the age of fighting with each other, but still There is one excellent quality in Kali Yuga. What is that quality? Kittanad eva Krishnasya mukta sanga parambrajet. If you can have the chance to do pure sankirtan, Harinam, Harikatha, Sankirtan, then Kali cannot do any harm to you. You can go very freely, cut material bondage and go unto the lotus feet of Prabhu to get eternal service. That is a facility. That's why Parikshit Maharaj not going to kill Kali. I can discuss someday anyway. Now today is the disappearance day of Madhavacharya ji, the great Acharya in the history of this spiritual world. Madhavacharya come this way. Actually, Madhavacharya also disappeared. I know today is the disappearance day. So, I already started with the sloka. If I have the chance to sing some glories of such a Vaishnava, Guru Vaishnava, who is a very elevated figure, and Krishna sitting inside their heart, if I have the chance to glorify their name and fame, everything, then I can get very easily the chance to get Nitya Seva. So today I have the chance to sing some glories of Srila Madhavacharya. Though it's a disappearance day of Madhavacharya, but be sure I can discuss gradually. The disappearance day of Madhavacharya doesn't mean Madhavacharya leave his body. Madhavacharya does disappear. Nobody can see. Where is Madhavacharya? Follow. I can discuss this point. How excellent. Now actually, I already discussed Viraha Tattva. Actually, Viraha Tattva is most important factor in spiritual line, bhajan line. Because suppose you are not getting any kind of detachment. You have so many attachment. You are not going to cut. Always attachment is there. Somehow you are trying, but you cannot get out. In that case, the easiest procedure open before you is to have the feeling of disappearance. Follow my disappearance means, Gurudev gone, Vaishnava gone. You cry. Your heart break down, then you can come out successful. What you cannot do, very easily, that is very easy, if you have the feeling of a disappearance feeling, a Baba, pain. If you get some pain inside heart, that Guru Varga gone, Prabhupada gone, Bhaktivinoda Thakur gone, this kind of feeling, pain, can put you in lap and give you vairagya. Vairagya mean? Detachment. Vairagya mean detachment. All other people, those who are not knowing anything about Gaudiya Darshan, they are going to take up travel and so much, astuity and penances. But actually, point is that astuti and penances, if you do without any tattva, backing of any tattva, it can make you dry. Your heart become dry. You cannot catch bhakti. So dry astuti and penances is totally strictly prohibited. Astuti and penances is not a big factor, but it should be in favor of Krishna bhakti. Anything what you are doing, all your activities, up, down, going, sleeping, eating, moving, anything, speaking, looking, anything what you do, it should have a relation with Krishna Bhakti. If you don't have any Krishna Bhakti, whatever you do is useless. You should have relation. So actually, Sarvam Bhattacharya already told you, time coming I can discuss all in detail. Vairagya vidya nija bhakti yoga. I cannot discuss in detail. Our vairagya, we Gaudiya, if we are really in line with Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Sauta Parampara, in that case our vairagya is not dry vairagya. Follow what I say. Our Vairagya is not for show. Our Vairagya is very sophisticated Vairagya. If the situation permit, I can throw out my cloth and put up coat, pant and try and speak Harikatha in front of foreign people. And after that I can throw again, put up, no problem in it. Because Yukta Vairagya is such a secret thing, by your logical interpretation you cannot understand. What is Yukta Vairagya? So balanced. Those who are gopikas, they are putting up new clothes and ornaments, everything for the total satisfaction of Krishna. So their Vairagya is topmost, whereas Hiranyakashipu doing swaying Vairagya is useless Vairagya. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu shouting in front of Shuklambar Brahmacharya, hey, what do you think? You are drinking milk, you think you can get my kippa? What do you think? Huh? You are drinking milk, you think you are pure, you can get me? Not that. Hiranyakashipu, he also doing astuti and finances, tapasya. And about the Hiranyakashipu, what region? Na bhutam na bhavishvati. In future, nobody can do. In past, nobody did. It's impossible, unparalleled, unbeaten. This kind of, you know, tapasya could not give any result, perfect result. What result? Ultimately, he was going to die. No bhakti. So this kind of Vairagya is totally prohibited in our line, Gaudiya channel. We honor this kind of Vairagya, which we can find with Bhaktivinoda Thakur, which kind of Vairagya we find with, you know, Prabhupad, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami, Swami Maharaj, Yukta Vairagya. It's called balance. Now, Srila Madhavacharya disappeared, so we are feeling heavily. Because that kind of big Acharya, excellent Acharya, we are missing today. But not actually missing. Actually, Tattva Siddhanta, his Bani, Bani mean speech and writing, everything there. So Guru Vaishnava is not a figure of blood and flesh. Guru Vaishnava is not a figure of blood and flesh. They can realize everything what is there inside your mind. Follow? So, Guru Vaishnava, to understand Guru Vaishnava, you must try to understand their Siddhanta, Vichar, all their glories you will have to Bani Vaibhav. Madhavacharya, what kind of upadesh giving, everything. So, Madhavacharya is still there with us. Really so, Madhavacharya is there with us through his Bani Vaibhav. At the same time, Madhavacharya when disappear, we can discuss this point. Madhavacharya disappeared. Nobody can see where is Madhavacharya. Nobody was found. Where is Madhavacharya? His disciple, you know, is writing that actually Madhavacharya, you know, got or you know, received order by Supreme Lord to go to Vasudev Asan Devadrikasram. So in one form, still today you can get Madhvacharya there in Vyasasan and another form in Urupi, his Bhajan pit. So in two forms. You should not disbelieve it. You should know the, you know, inconceivable power of Madhvacharya. Why? He is not like ordinary Acharya. He is not like ordinary Acharya. All four Acharyas, they are not ordinary Acharya. I can discuss tomorrow. Srila Ramanuja Acharya, Srila Ramanuja Acharya is a Ram Anuja. Ramanuja Acharya means Ram Anuja. I mean younger brother of Ramchand, I mean Lakshman. Madhvacharya is the incarnation of principal Vayu, Pradhan Vayu. There is so many evidence in Shastra, one by one you can find, you can see that Vayu has some certain very important role to play in creation also. How this star and planets actually Vaikuntha Dham, everything, hold on. It is driven by Pradhan Vayu. Very nice. Anantadev actually holding. So actually, Madhavacharya is an incarnation of principal Vayu. We know five kind of Vayu, air, inside here. Pran, Apan, Udan, Saman, Ban, Apan, Udan, Saman, this kind of four kind of Vayu, Vayu there. Pran Vayu, five. So it's five. Five Vayu actually controlling all your material body. This body, you can find nothing. Only blood and flesh, dirty thing. If you can understand this, very shortly you can hate your body. This is the condition of body. Always some kind of ailments, ill, you know, I become ill, this kind of dirty, stool and urine, everything, oh, useless. It's of no use. But it is, you can use this body, 100% you can use this body, and a condition is, suppose you are going to get full kippa of Guru Vishnu. In that case, you can use this body very nice way and come out successful. But if you are not, you know, in line, then unnecessarily you can feel pain, some kind of attraction, some kind of repulsion, some kind of illness, everything can give you pain in your whole life. You cannot do proper bhajan. Before starting bhajan, I already told you many times. First of all, you should try to go out of attraction and repulsion. It is not a matter of joke, though it is a preliminary thing. Attraction and repulsion, to go cut this attraction and repulsion, not a matter of joke, but still, it is a preliminary thing in bhajan. If you are not successful, you cannot do bhajan. Preliminary thing, very preliminary. Otherwise, you cannot start your bhajan. There should not be any attraction and repulsion. Repulsion means, I hate that man. Why he come in front of me? Oh, I like very much. Come. Attraction and repulsion. Any object, any man, woman, they are always feeling some sort of attraction and repulsion. It is my request, you should go out of attraction and repulsion first. Go on hearing Harikatha and try to feel this body is made up of blood and flesh. Very shortly I am going to leave my body. No use if I cannot do perfect bhajan. This first. Now actually, this five Vayu, air, pran, apan, udan, saman, ban, these five Vayus controlling your whole body. Just yogis, they know it very clearly. You can also know, but no, you actually, that, so you see, so they are giving you a nice balance to protect your body, otherwise you cannot protect your body. It's five Vayus. Now actually, this prana, actually mul Vayu, original Vayu is pradhan Vayu. Pradhan is actually pavande. And you already know, in Teta Yuga, Pavan Putra Hanuman, Anjana Srato. Pavan Putra Hanuman? Pavan Putra Hanuman singing very nicely, because he came to serve Ramchandra. Mere man mein base hai Ram, mene tan mein base hai Ram. All my limbs, you can find Ram is there. Oh, everywhere Ram. So, it's a nice song. At the time of Ram Nam, you say, Mere man mein base hai Ram, Mere man mein base hai Ram, Mere tan mein base hai Ram, Mere man mein base hai Ram. Everywhere Ram. You can search, you can find Ram is there. So, a pure devotee, always Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is always there. Nityananda. Otherwise, how possible? So, this way you see, in Teta Yuga, Pavan Putra, Hanumanji Maharaj, took birth here as Anjana Sutta to serve Ramchandra. And same, you know, Pradhan Vayu in Dapar Yuga came as a son of Kunti Devi. He is a Bhimsena. Eh? And that Pradhan Vayu came in the form of Madhvacharya in this Kali Yuga. Actually, it is written there in Mahabharata, Moksha Parva, I think so. It is written there, Pitama Visha, while giving advice, different kind of advice to Pancha Pandava, and so many Rishi Mani standing, there Pitama Visha already forecast that when Kali going to cover 4,300 years, after that, this Kunti Putra going to take birth. 4,300 years of Kali, if it is over, then you can find that actually Kunti Putra again going to come back. So many things there, but I am interested about Pradhan Vayu, I mean Pavan Putra. Madhvacharya is a incarnation of principal Vayu. There is no doubt, there is so many documents there in Vayu Puran, here, there, Mahabharata, so many, no doubt in it. Madhvacharya is the incarnation of Pradhan Vayu avatar. At the appearance day of Madhvacharya, then in Dasami Tithi, Durga Puja Dasami Tithi, at Madhvacharya Avirbhav Tithi, if I have chance, I can discuss all about this in details. Now today, we are very much interested about Madhvacharya's power, how he was doing this kind of seva. Because by the order of Supreme Lord, Pradhan Vayu, Principal Vayu, came here in this material world, in the house of Narayan Bhatta and Bedvati Devi, where actually there is a nice place there in Paja Khetra. But first of all, I should touch this point, Urupi. So many points, countless, infinity. How I can discuss? I can touch only. Urupi, you know already Urupi Khetra in South India, a very nice place, Madhvacharya Pit. Now, Urupi, this word, where from you get this Urupi? This word, where from you, this word came? Urupi. Uru means actually Chandrama. P mean pit, you can say, or is a principal star, Urupi. There is a very old history, I mean in from Puran, you can find this point, that Chandrama was cursed by Daksha. Chandrama was cursed by Daksha. You can develop TV. For TV? Why? Because you know, Daksha, 27 daughters of Daksha, Chandrama married 27 daughters of Daksha. But by chance, I don't know why, that's why I told you, try to go out of attraction and repulsion, I told you. But Chandrama was attracted by only one wife, his name is Revati. All day and night busy, all other wives, they are crying. Husband not taking care of us. No, they never love us. Then they lodge one complaint with Daksha. Father, your son-in-law never take care of us. Only he is busy with one wife actually. Who? Revati. Oh, they are crying. And Daksha began, it is injustice. It's not good. Why? Chandrama cannot give any answer because he is actually attraction and repulsion. What to speak about? You know? You already know that the case of, you know, that Raja? Chitraketu Raja? So many wives, only one wife. This is not good. So ultimately what happens? What problem? The Dakha curse. You can develop, you know? You can develop TB. Khoirog. But the TV, you know, in the form of these material people, what kind of TV is visible, not that. Then in, you know, is going to lose all his power, everything. Then Chandrama, what to do? No way. Chandrama came in Udupi Khetra, there, and started doing bhajan of Shankar Bhagavan. Shankar Bhagavan came, what you want? Then he blessed me, this is the condition. Then after that, by the mercy of Shankar Bhagavan, he is going to get his whole body in Purnima time, and again, I mean, both can be balanced. I mean, Dakha curse, and you know, Sivji Maharaj bless. So to keep balance nicely, so gradually, within 15 days, he can lose all his, you know, color, and after that, again going to revive a full body. This way, to keep balance, now Chandrama, you can say, from then, you can see, you know, Amavasya, lunar, and, you know, dark moon and full moon. This way we get from there. This is called Urupi. From there, if you go seven kilometers away towards southeast. Southeast corner, if you move 7 kilometers, there you can find one Papanasan Khetra. Papanasan? Papanasan Nadi River, very nice. There you can find one hill, big hill. It's called Bimangiri. Its name? Bimangiri. And in that Bimangiri, actually Parshuramji Maharaj went there. Out of his own power, in four corners of that Bimangiri hill, big parbat, he make four auspicious kunda. Very nice. One is Parshuram, another is Ban, actually Dhanush Tīrtha, Ban Tīrtha, Gada Tīrtha, and Parshuram Khetra. This way actually four kunda making. Now from Dhanush Kunda, if you go one mile, 7 mile, I already told from Murubi, 7 mile if you go, southeast, you can find this Tīrtha. And there Parshuramji making four kunda in hill, very nice. And this actually Dhanush Tīrtha, very important Tīrtha. From there, if you go another 1 mile, you can find one village, the name is Panja Khetra. Panja Khetra, very important place. There actually, Madhavacharya ji took birth. I can discuss all in detail about Abhirbhav Tithi, not in details now, no time. Actually, they are very, very, very pure Brahman, who? Narayan Bhatta and Vedbhuti Maharaj. Divine, you know, nice couple, Brahman couple. They are actually doing nice bhajan to satisfy Anantadev. Because Anantashwar Mandir was there. Anantashwar Mandir was there near their house, not long distance. Anantashwar Bhagavan, Vishnu. Anantashwar Vishnu. Why they are taking so much trouble? Because actually they lose their two sons. Two sons took birth and died. They are crying, we have no son, nothing. We like to get such a son who is not going to die. That kind of son we need. That's why they started doing payabrata, only drinking milk for 12 years. You can go mad. 12 years, only drinking milk, nothing. Water milk. They drink. After that, Supreme Lord was sacked. Oh, I will have to do something for them. After that, Anantadev came in dream and blessed them. After that, this Madhvacharya came in the womb of mother. After that, he took birth and he was so excellent, powerful and so excellent, talented. It is not possible in this material world. From childhood, he was very, you know, so nice. So one day, when he just started crawling, and after crawling, you know, starting with this, started when baby is start with this, you know, knee and hand. After they started standing, looking at mother and smiling, then mother thought this is the right time, I can take this boy and go to Anantadev, because by the mercy of Anantishwar I get. So Anantadev, she reached Anantadev temple, Anantishwar, and take this boy, Prabhu is your, is one gift I give you. Like Prabhupad is a gift from Jagannath, you know already. So this way, after that, after worshipping, giving tulsi, garland, everything, after that, she and so many devotees coming back to his village, where Panja Khetra, but that is almost forest. Not full forest, but almost forest. At night time they are coming, whole day gone, they are worshipping, dancing, singing, worshipping this gone. Now almost, you know, evening over, night. Then in the midway, there is which, you know, ghost. A ghost actually catch one man and he is vomiting blood. Everybody was afraid. What is this? How he is vomiting blood? Then that ghost started speaking in the mouth of that man whom he catch. Actually, by the mercy of this small boy, you all are saved. Because you are already, you love him. But that man not loving him, that's why I have the power to catch him. I can kill him. Then that small boy, by his blessing, that ghost gone. And that man was saved. Everybody, your mother, this sarpa, how possible this boy is very small. By a small boy, but what to do? Very nice. That boy actually now coming back. From very childhood, he started expressing Shuddha Bhakti. One instant I can speak. One day, father, mother, they going to a relative house. There is a big function. But that function, material function. Maybe some marriage is there, I don't know. There's big function. That boy, they took in lap. The father, mother, take there. But the boy, there going and don't like to stay there in this material, you know. Father, mother, busy with relatives. In the meantime, how possible that small boy gone? Where gone? He gone to some temple. Nearby temple, gone. And whole day gone, everybody searching. No, he cannot say. Ultimately, the boy gone to Anantashwar temple. And they are worshipping, dancing, singing. Oh, everybody crying, where's our boy gone? Die or something? Of searching? After that, they see that boy there in Anantashwar temple, blessing them. So many incidents. When that boy was very small, took birth, one pure Brahman there, give in donation one very nice cow. Cow, very nice cow. Surabhi cow. Give donation. And the small boy loving that cow, Gomata, so much. He kissing and moving always all the time. One day, that boy, without any notice, gone to forest with the cow, catching his tail. Whole day gone, everybody crying, mother almost dying. Then one coward boy heard that they are crying for their own boy. He said, no, come on. I see that boy in field, there in the forest. He is dancing there. So sweet dancing and singing. Where? There with a, you know, Gomata's tail, catching and dancing. Yeah? They go and saw the boy is there. This way actually. So many supernatural incident. One day, father going to buy one ox. Ox, you know. One day, his father, Narayan Bhatta, wanted to buy one ox. Because some reason can be there. But the price is not there, they are very poor. Actually, they are very poor. Poor mean there is, you know, leap and a very unstable heart. Very nice. Bamboo structure, this, that, you know, creeper, lata pata, they make nice. So father wanted to buy one ox. So mother speaking, my son, you go there, your father is there. You call, because prasadam time is ready. You call. Then boy going. Boy going there, father, mother calling you. Oh, I can go. Now I am talking with this man who is coming here to sell this ox. So I have to pay him. I have not a sufficient money. So I have to talk with him how to pay. Father, I can pay. How you can pay? It's very small boy. He coming, going to room and giving some paddy. Paddy, you know, in hand like Krishna. Krishna doing in his, you know, Vrindavan Leela. When buying some fruits, in exchange giving some paddy, this much paddy. Very small hand, paddy. Krishna giving to the, there in Vrindavan Leela, same Leela. He is catching some paddy and going to the man who is coming here to sell that ox. I can pay you, you take it. That man looking at his face, he forget everything. And Narayan Bhattu said, never mind, he's a small boy, actually crazy. No, I already get my payment. You get payment? Yes. By smiling face, he's not ordinary boy. Narayan Bhattu said, what him? You need not pay anymore, it's balanced already. This way, actually, Madhvacharya, right from the very childhood, doing so many nice lila. After that, that boy started reading. Kha, you know, alphabet, a language, A, B, C, D, you are learning. Then started. Very shortly, in one day, 1 or 2 days learning everything. Over. Hey, read. No, already finish. I finish? Yes. Then after that, he grown up and showing extraordinary, you know, brain. Memory power, everybody. All basic learning, grammar, everything finished very shortly. After that, he was sent to a nice Brahman, powerful Brahman there to learn Vedanta. Madhvacharya going. Then within very short time, he learned all Vedanta, everything. But basically, nobody can understand. But the power of, you know, this Madhvacharya. So one day that you know, Acharya, I mean teacher. Teacher means Acharya. He chided him very, hey, you are playing all day and night, not reading? Because Madhvacharya almost whole day playing with small boys, jumping, swimming, this the whole day. One day Acharya catching. I can beat you. Whole day you are playing? When you can learn? Actually, unnecessarily you are chiding me. You ask me, I can speak everything. Then he is speaking, sitting. All he learned, already the lesson not giving as yet. Everything speaking. Madhaji was thinking, unnecessarily you are chiding me. For this small reading, how much time I can give this for lesson small? And all reciting everything. Acharya, I mean teacher became very mad, how possible? He went on speaking everything. He says, not ordinary boy. After learning Vedanta everything, he's coming back to home and in a very playing mood, taking one dry stick of one tree. Catch, one tree. I mean, dry stick, one tree. I'm coming in front of father. Father, what happens? Actually, I already complete my Veda. Yes. Now, I like to break the Siddhanta of Mayavadi. Shankaracharya Mayavadi left to break and throw. How possible? Foolish you are. It is not possible for you. You are an ordinary boy. The dry stick there, one dry stick is there. If it is possible for you, if it is possible for the dry stick, to become a big tree, one dry twig is there. Even if it is possible that this dry twig become a big tree, then I can believe that an ordinary boy like you can preach and break Mayavad. Oh, really? My father, actually point is that by the mercy of Prabhu, everything is possible. Let me see what happened. Then the dry stick he put in inside mud, I mean ground. Then within fraction of second it grow into big trees. Big trees. Father, yes. What happens? This dry stick become big tree. Then Narayan Bhatta could realize it's not an ordinary boy. Yes, it can be possible for you. Now after that, actually, this Madhavacharya started expressing himself onward, today, day by day. He is going to one ashram there, and some temple there nearby, Rajatpur, there. There is some Achyuta Prekha, from whom Madhavacharya took sannyas. From whom Madhavacharya took sannyas is that Achyuta Prekha. His Gurudev is Sri Peksha like that. I forget, I can remember. So there actually, that time, Achyuta Prekha, actually Madhavacharya took travel to serve that pure Vaishnava for 1 year. I told you, na, it is very easy for you to get success if you can have the chance to serve a pure Vaishnava. So he stayed with going there and serving that Achyuta Prekha, pure devotee, for 1 year. Then he is developing by the mercy. And there already, in front of Achyuta Prekha, he is explaining on Veda, Vedanta, Upanishad. Nice way. Achyuta Prekha becomes stunned. How possible? This boy is only 10 years. They are speaking everything and giving explanation, I mean commentary on different kind of Upanishad. And Gurudev become mad. You will have to write, you know, commentary of Vedanta. Can you? Yes. By your mercy I can do. Then by the mercy of Gurudev, it's as such, by the mercy of Gurudev. Actually he is all powerful. But by the mercy of Gurudev, he is started expressing himself. Now I like to establish one nice Siddhanta that I told that Vishnupriya day, that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took permission from Sachidevi to take sannyas. It is the usual rule. It is the usual rule in this society, if somebody like to take sannyas, it is good if he can take permission from mother. But it is not actually Siddhanta. If you have loveful relation with mother, and here the mother of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Bhakti Devi, who? Sachi Mata. So here is an exclusive case. Here case is exclusive. You cannot compare your case with their case, with his case. So actually Madhavacharya wanted to establish first Siddhanta. It is not 100% necessary that you will have to take permission from mother. Because all world, is a property of Krishna. Our whole world is a servant of Krishna. Vishnu? So who is? Vishnu is father, Vishnu is mother, everything. We know already. Tameva mata chapita tameva, tameva bandhusya sakha tameva, tameva vidvam dravinam tameva, tameva sarvam mama deva deva. It is written there. Hey Prabhu, you are my father, you are my mother, you are everything, all property, all everything what I can see, what I cannot see, all you whom to serve? Vishnu, the powering Lord. Follow? This is the actual Siddhanta. Tameva mata chapita me veyo, tameva tameva vandish. You are friend, you are foe, everything, you. So whom to worship? Actually like to worship you. So these are Siddhanta, main Siddhanta. established by Madhavacharya. But before that, I like to stay one, two, three incident more. What kind of a, in village, Pajakhetra, there one Brahman, you know, reciting Pūrna. The boy is there with father and mother, listening. And that small boy started reciting everything. Why, who is, you know, reading Pūrna, he is speaking one time, he is speaking all sloka, everything. He is gone mad, how possible? Another time, in a temple, in Brahman Samaj, there, some Brahman actually reading some Pūrna. And Madhavacharya, the small boy sitting, and suddenly he is shouting. What kind of explanation you are giving? Eh? Eh? No devotion? You like to satisfy this audience? It's not good. What kind of benefit you can do for you and for them? It's not good. Small boy speaking in front of that Brahman, big, you know, this reading Pūrna for a long time. Your reading Pūrna is not good. You are not speaking right Siddhanta. There is rasa in this Pūrna. You are speaking Pūrna devoid of any bhakti. It's not good. Then he started explaining Pūrna. Everybody laughing. How possible this small boy reciting, you know, Pūrna so nicely, so nice commentary. Follow, you see, this way. So, one day in front of Achyuta Prakha, he is explaining, you know, giving commentary of Upanishadha. All demigods came. Achyuta Prakha could see, pure devotee. All demigods praying. They are praying Madhvacharya. The reason for why you are coming here, you cut all Mayavadi and establish Bhakti Siddhanta. Well, then Achyuta Prakha giving an order, very nice order, blessing. After that, Madhvacharya giving commitment. Yes, I can do very shortly. In front of father also, you know already I told, father, I can cut all Mayavad Siddhanta. Really? Then already father started believing. Yes, it's possible for this kind of, you know. After that, without taking any permission of father and mother, one day lonely, running to take sannyas, there in Rajatpur, there in front of, from whom? Achyuta Prakha. So he wanted to prove, it is not 100% necessary to take permission of father. Yes, if your mother is devotee, big devotee, follow. Here one point, sweet point. Mahaprabhu not making any mistake. Actually, if your mother is very nice devotee, very nice, elevated, in that case, you know, you should give consolation that I am throwing myself, I like to throw myself in Krishna Seva. You should be satisfied with that. So what, you should not cry. This one Siddhanta. So Madhvacharya, right from the beginning, started establishing nice Siddhanta. It is not 100% necessary to take permission from father, mother to take sannyas. Because who is going to get permission? Your father, mother can give permission? Nobody can give permission. Oh, you don't go. You stay here, serve me. Every father, mother speaking, serve me. So they like to engage. This is the system. So who is going to live son? My mother also crying, going to die. Father already died. This is what to do? Eh? If I am going to America to do service, then mother is very happy. Ah, my son staying in America. Eh? I told you, why you are coming? Crying, eh? If I am going to America, like my friend staying in America, and mother dancing, eh? I am here doing bhajan, you are crying? Stop crying. So this is a system. No need of any permission. If mother and father is great devotee, then is a question of taking permission. Come. Anyway, after that, taking sannyas, Madhvacharya took the name, Madhvacharya, his name was Madhvacharya. His name was Madhavacharya. And small boy, his name was, his name was very sweet name. Anyway, he's a small boy. But now, after sannyas, his name was Madhavacharya. Madhu means honey. There is some explanation of his name. Fully dedicated show unto the lotus feet of Vishnu, Ananteshwar. Then after that, he take commitment, I'm going to, you know, explain properly about all Ved, Vedanta, Upanishad, everything. One day Madhavacharya reached, you know, Kerala, his kingdom is, what name? Kerala actually, the city, Kerala, Trivandrum, yes. Trivandrum, I forget, I remember everything, sometimes I forget. Trivandrum reaching there in temple, Madhavacharya recite, giving right explanation of Vedanta. That time, Shankaracharya coming, Kalodi, this kind of place. Actually, Shankaracharya, when I am going to discuss about Mayavad Siddhanta, to break, cut Mayavad Siddhanta, I can speak in details. Now you know it for sure. It is already written in their book also that Shankaracharya took birth two times. One time in Kalodi, this kind of place, near Trivandrum. Another time, Kumbakonam. One place is that, Kumbakonam, one place. Their second birth was there. Now, actually, point is that, Shankaracharya took birth much before Madhavacharya. Follow what I say. Shankaracharya took birth much before Madhavacharya. At the year of 1200, you know, BC, I think so. I forget. Actually, this is actually 2019, like at the year of 2000 or before that, Shankaracharya took birth, around that time. But Madhavacharya, I already told you, when Kali already passing away, 4,300 years over, now at present, actually, you can add another 100 years, because 100 years gone, but that was written long ago. Follow what I say. So actually, almost 7, that time it was 660, or now it is around 700, 640 that time, 30 or 40, on 7 like that. So, a tentative calculation. So, Shankaracharya took birth much before Madhavacharya. Where from Shankaracharya coming? You can put question. But be sure that Shankaracharya second time took birth in Kumbakonam. He came at the time of Madhavacharya. When Madhavacharya reciting Vedanta, then Shankaracharya came and fighting with him. Hey, you are doing wrong. Madhavacharya, why I am doing wrong? You have any Vedanta, Vasya, commentary? Without commentary, how you are passing this kind of remark? Madhavacharya, you are totally wrong. I am speaking from Siddhanta, all scripture. You can break if you like to break. This kind of heart. That time actually, Shankaracharya was defeated by Madhavacharya. Shankaracharya was defeated by Madhavacharya. Couldn't establish Siddhanta. From there actually, Madhavacharya two times Madhavacharya in his whole life, two times, At the age of 79, his body vanished, disappearance. But up to that point, in this whole life, two times Madhavacharya going to Bodhikasam. Or maybe three times, because after living body also going three times. So in his living period, Madhavacharya going to where? Madhavacharya going to Badrikaswam. There Naro Narayan. Here is Naro, here is Narayan. two hill there, Naranarayan, Bhagavan. And in Narayan hill, you can find Badhikasam, Badhinarayan Bhagavan, Uddhavji Maharaj, Ganapati Mahadev, Naraji Maharaj, all there, deities. I went long ago, many times, by the mercy of Guru Maharaj. Even I climbed the Gomukh, after that I go. It's not possible. I was about to fall down, by the mercy of Guru Das. A long history I can speak after. By the mercy of Guru Maharaj, so if you can understand, you are a very, very small creature. Go and watch Badrikasram, Badri Vishal. You can discover that you are a so small power. I realized by the mercy of. Then I was bound to become a humble person. But not 100%, today also I am not humble. Still, some kind of humbleness came by looking at that. So actually, Bas Gupa also I went. So long history. They actually, Madhavacharya went there. And actually, in their Badhikasam, he started giving commentary on Gita. Oh, nice commentary. Automatically, like, you know, wind coming. One day when he was giving some explanation of Upanishad, dark blue color appeared in sky, some light. And coming gradually in front of Madhavacharya and submerged with his face. Then all, you know, disciples, they gone mad. What is this? Madhavacharya could realize that Vyasadeva, Gurudev, inviting me. They request all disciples not to follow me. Don't follow me. I am supposed to come back, or if it is the desire of Supreme Lord, I cannot come back. But don't follow me. If I am alive, I can come back. Then, taking permission from those disciples crying, Gurudev going away, he is climbing hills and reach that Swaraswati Nadi, there where Badhika Swam, there Vyasa Gufa, and you know, that time Vyasadev standing up inside Gufa, coming out and embrace Madhavacharya, bless him. By the mercy of Vyasadeva, he got full exact commentary of what? You know, Vedanta, Upanishad, everything all taught by Vyasadeva. All taught by Vyasadeva. So it is actually, to be frank, actually Madhvacharya is a disciple of Vyasadeva. Because of Vyasadeva, Shaktavis avatar of Supreme Lord, having what kind of Siddhanta Shaktavis avatar having, same we can get intact toto from Madhvacharya. But someday, if you are going to do bhajan day by day, someday I can quote some point where you can find some disparity from Madhvacharya. Right now I cannot speak, you can go mad, you cannot believe. So this kind of disparity also have some mystery. That I can discuss after, not right now. Actually, I started with point you can remember that Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking already, those who are not going to confess that we are in the lineage of Madhva Gauriya Sampradaya, they are actually number one spy of Kali. I already told, Prabhupada already told. So we are anyway not going to break this principle. We are going to believe that Madhavacharya, we are in the line of Madhavacharya. How? So many people in recent period also in Vrindavan here were fighting going on. We are not in this lineage. Foolish people fighting. Whereas Bhaktivinoda Thakur already told, you know, Dhamma Parikram. Dham Parikam, Dham Mahima, glorification of Dhamma. In this book, Bhaktivinoda Thakur already writing, all four Acharyas came in this Dham. Be sure. All these four Acharyas, authentic Acharyas, Madhavacharya, Ramanuja Acharya, even Sankaracharya, is not within these four Acharyas. Madhavacharya, Nimbarkacharya, Vishnu Swami, Nimbarkacharya, Ramanuja Swami, or even Shankaracharya also. When Shankaracharya came here in Rudradip, Mahaprabhu appeared. Gauranga, hey, this is not the right place for you to preach Mahavad. Go! Mahaprabhu already appeared. Though that time the appearance of Mahaprabhu was not there. But it is Nityodham. It is Nityodham, na? Navadip Dham. So you can see. You see, at the time of, you know, Shatta Yuga, you know, they, you know, when Ganga came, Bhagirath Maharaj, Ganga coming this way, Bhagirath Maharaj, mother, why you are going this way? Have some reason, stop. You go, you know, you have some reason for why I bring you. I can go, but Gaur Purnima coming, I have to go here to take keep up. Go, huh? What? Yes, long ago, not now. Long ago, Bhagirath Maharaj bringing Ganga from Himalaya, that time also. So it's a long history. So why Ganga coming this way? Supposed to go that way? Not going. Actually coming this way. So actually, while I speak, Shankaracharya came here long before the appearance of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. 1407 je Phalgun Mas. 1407 me? Shak means Bengali calendar. So, Shak is the Bengali calendar. 1407. Eh? And 1455, Mahaprabhu disappeared. 1407, you know, Bengali calendar hisab, take birth. So, long before that, Shankaracharya came. After that, onward, one by one, four Acharya came here, you know. When Madhavacharya came, then Mahaprabhu coming and blessing him. I am very satisfied with you. You are the disciple of Madhavacharya, Vyasadeva. Be sure, in Kalikal, I am going to, Kalikal, late Kalikal, I am going to take birth and I am going to accept your channel, Parampara. In Damparikrama, you can go through Damparikrama and find Bhaktivinoda already give evidence from different scriptures that I am going to accept your parampara, Madhavacharya, blessing. Eh? No other Acharya getting this kind of kipa. So Madhavacharya now, actually Madhavacharya, actually Vyasadeva give proof, actually it is written that Madhavacharya is a disciple of Vyasadeva. Anyway, if you can know all Siddhanta and knowledge, everything Kripa from Sambandha Jnana, you see, why Parikhit Maharaj can consider that Sukadeva Goswami is my Guru? What kind of mantra he received from Gurudev? Only here Bhagavatam. Bhagavatam itself is the outcome of all mantra. So why not we can say that he is the disciple of Sukadev Goswami, right, is the disciple of Sukadev, because all excellent bhakti appear by hearing Bhagavatam. So no problem actually. So this way we can consider that he is the disciple of Vyasadeva. So after that he coming and after that started preaching big way. Achyutaprekha, his Gurudev, they fearing very much. Because all Sankar Sampradaya attacking them. Shankaracharya living before living body give instruction. Somehow Sri Pekka, you have to change his decision. Somehow, by operation, by hook and crook, you have to change. Otherwise, we cannot stand. Mayava Siddhanta can break. Then by his instruction, they are giving operation, attack, sometime fire, this going on. So much operation was, you know, done on Achyutaprekha, his Gurudev. They are crying, what to, where to go? No way. That time, they put Tripunda, they put Tilak, this. They cannot do this kind of Urdhapanda Tilak. They fight with them. You have to do this Tilak. They put this Tilak, and you will have to Soham. Soham, this mantra you will have to recite This mantra you have to japa. You have to do swaham, 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 swaham. You have to. Oh my God. They can kill. So they are bound to keep stop, keep silence, and inside they are doing Vishnu Bhajan. Outside, if they change the tilak and doing everything, they can fight. So, you know. But when Madhavacharya appear, I mean Vasudev, Madhavacharya's childhood name was Vasudev. Now I remember. I know everything, forget sometimes. Vasudev. Vasudev. So at the appearance of Vasudev, Madhavacharya, they feel, you know, without any fear. And day by day, when Madhavacharya manifest, then all Mayava started cutting and throwing Madhavacharya, one by one. They cannot stand, just one by one, writing commentaries, so many books. All Upanishad, you know, Vedanta, you know, and you see, about Bhagavatam also, so actually Madhavacharya going two times there to meet Vyasadeva there. You know. So this way. Madhavacharya is a principal vayu. See, Pradhan Vayu Avatar. Endless power, enormous power, so powerful you cannot believe. You cannot believe. So powerful. One day, almost 1,000 people trying to get one rock, big rock, to protect landslide of river. They wanted to put that rock, big rock, 1,000 people trying, pulling. They cannot do. Madhavacharya laughing. What happens? We cannot care. Go, go, go. In one hand, he take this big land, you know, almost one hill. One hand, and come, where to put? There. Put. One man was so powerful that he deserved 300 people cannot defeat him. One day, Madhavacharya, he is giving challenge to Madhavacharya. Madhavacharya laughing. Madhavacharya say, I am going to put my, you know, toe in land. So if you can, displace is very good. He put his, you know, toe in land. And he with full power cannot, you know, move. They could realize the power of Madhavacharya. Actually, Madhavacharya, one day after coming back from Basa Gufa, Badhika Sam, one day, Madhavacharya going to take bath in sea, Samudra. In the way, he is writing 5 chapters of Krishna Stotra. You know, how you can believe? Is Siddhanta, you know, Vishnu is the topmost, and Brahma is the Adiguru. Whereas we see, he is writing 5 chapters of Krishna Lila. Only going in the road, is going to Samudra. 5 chapters complete. After that, going to sea, taking bath and sitting. After that, he finds one ship, big, you know, the shipman actually is one kind of big, cannot move. It is already got stuck up in sand. Sand cannot move. Water, you know, they cannot flow, you know, float in water. He is crying that the owner of the ship is crying. Suddenly look in a down there in the sea beach, one sadhu is sitting this way. He's crying. You see. Madhavacharya only showing one, you know, mudra one. Suddenly the boat float in water. Everybody started dancing. Then that owner of the ship requested him to accept some article from my ship. Because I am to do business long. Now, by your mercy, I am free. Because for a long time I was there. I cannot move. Now, by his mudra, that boat started floating and now moving. Then Madhavacharya said, well, I don't need anything. If you at all want to give anything, you have Gopi Chandan, Gopi Talab. I like to get some Gopichandan. Then that owner of the land, ship, he get one big Gopichandan from ship and throw. Follow. And Mata Jaja take that Gopichandan, take in one and big, like one rock, take and coming to, you know, his bhajan pit. In the meantime, in midway, that Gopichandan break up. Gopichandan break up. How nice he discovered there is one Gopal dancing with in a makan and a danda. Nice Gopal. Oh my God, it's Gopal. Madhavacharya take in lap, you know, embrace and take the in and the, there is Sarabar, Ananta Sarabar, there, you know, do Abhishek, then go inside and establish this deity. It is already established because from long time it is there. So there, Madhavacharya, there still today you can find Madhavacharya, that deity there. Still there, you can find. Madhavacharya give nice arrangement among their disciple, 12 disciples, I think, 10 or 12, I forget. I mean, eight benches of Acharya. So Madhavacharya give instruction, Rishikesh Acharya, all other Acharya, Vishnu Tirtha, actually Vishnu Tirtha is the younger brother of Madhavacharya. When Madhavacharya gone away from home at the age of 12, then that boy took birth and grown up, and he lived home and come back to stay with elder brother Madhavacharya. But Madhavacharya request him, you go my father mother there, after you can come. Then Madhavacharya send the younger brother who got the name Vishnu Tirtha after. Actually he is the younger brother of Madhavacharya. Follow why is it? He gone home, after some time, long time over, Madhavacharya reach some place near house and bring small brother and give sannyas and take him as Acharya. Bridge, 8 Acharya there, at present also if I. Then Madhavacharya give arrangement, every 2 years you will have to take seva of this Gopal. Follow what I say. Or every Acharya, every 2 years you will have to take seva. Responsibility, and one Acharya taking seva, all other Acharya going to help him in different way. How different way? Like Shastra, teaching of Shastra, this, that, preaching, they can do this way. So this way, they are always busy, giving lesson to new disciple, everything, newcomer coming, they are giving lesson to them. This way, big preaching, massive preaching going on, in a very harmonized way. So Madhavacharya now actually is a big preacher actually now going on, big preaching. And big preaching going on, all Mayavadi Sampradaya Acharya is going to break the Siddhartha. Sometime they are taking shelter of Madhavacharya this way. This way Madhavacharya is going on doing this kind of preaching. Actually it is a system written there. Those who are sannyasi, they can touch that vigraha and do seva. Those who are brahmachari, without touching the vigraha, it is a system to do seva. But anyway, if there is any mistake, then one black snake can come to thread them, not cutting. Black snake coming. And they pray, if any mistake, we excuse, then the black snake. This is the system, still today. Actually, Madhavacharya wanted to protect all secret Siddhanta what he got from Vyasadeva. But who can say someday Mayavadi can come and destroy everything? I can discuss something tomorrow. How Ramanujaya was attacked this way, I can. You can go mad. So Madhavacharya told you, by the mercy of Krishna, I must keep some protection of Mool Tattva Siddhanta, I mean like formula. In copper plate, he, you know, write everything, and all copper plate, one by one, he make and put inside mud and cover up and make one temple. And there the black snake always protecting that place. Nobody can steal that property. Atta Madhavacharya gone, that copper plate was rescued, and from there different scriptures was, you know, expressed. Because Mahabadi by the so many books and, you know, writings, I mean, that time books mean, I mean, plumpet. So that was destroyed many times. So by chance it was protected. I can also discuss how Ramanujaja crying. I can discuss some. So this way all protected form was there. This way Madhavacharya going to establish everything. Now point is that Madhavacharya confessed that my Adi Guru is Brahma. Point is, big Siddhanta here. Try to remember. Madhavacharya 100% believe my Adi Guru is Brahma. Point. Now Adi Guru Brahma, he is getting mantra from where? From Krishna. Krishna ite chaturmukha hai Krishna sevanmu. Brahma ite narade ramati. Narada haite vyas madhuka hai. Already here. So, his mother, Brahma is getting mantra from Krishna. But many people fighting. Madhavacharya Sampradaya, they don't have any rasa tattva, nothing. Foolish. How possible? Whereas Brahma getting mantra, Ashtadasakhar mantra. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, he says, rasa upasana is only done, can be done by Ashtadasakhar mantra, Dasakhar mantra, Mahaprabhu got from. Is that somehow? Both mantras there in our Sampradaya. So how possible? Whereas Brahma got this mantra, Ashtadas mantra, Ashtadas akshara mantra. This is the main thing of Rasapasana. So how you can say Brahma has have no feeling? Maybe Brahma can express this kind of mood by the mercy of Krishna. Because different Acharya, they are, you know, expressing themselves up to that point. Up to what point? They are advised by Krishna. Hey, you can go up to this point. So, not that they don't know. So, Brahma not knowing any rasa tattva, nothing. Brahma foolish. Who say? Who is going to speak this way? Is this Siddhanta is not good. So, you see, Brahma having rasa tattva upasana. So, if Madhavacharya is in line with Brahma, why not? We can say the Madhavacharya also having rasa upasana system. Prabhupad writing so many things. I can show you someday. Eight branch, they are dancing like gopi. Sweetly. Like gopi. Madhusudan Saraswati were writing later. That Madhusudan, that's the one Vaishnava. From Vrindavan, write one later. Prabhupad saying they have rasa tattva, but nobody can believe. Nobody can understand. So this way, big fighting going on among devotees. Brahma is in Rasatattva, having Rasatattva, not having Rasatattva, Madhavacharya writing this, that. So many fighting going on. I can discuss this point after. But anyway, you should believe that Madhavacharya, Siddhanta, almost all the same with the Siddhanta Mahaprabhu spoke. Follow what I say? We Gaudiya devotees having rise Siddhanta by the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Amnaya praha tathya harimiha sarvasaktim rasadhim. Amnaya praha tathyam. Amnaya praha tathyam. Then after that, I always speak, now forget. Amnaya praha tathyam harimiha sarvasaktim rasadhim. Tad binnang shangsha jivano kapriti kabalitano, tad bimuktang shabhavat, bheda bheda sakalamo piharehe, suddha bhaktim, sadham tad pirtimeva iti upadeshati, gaura chando swayamswa, amnaya praha tatyam harimiya sarva saktim rasadin, tad binnang shangsha jivano prakriti kabalitano, tad bimuktang shubhavad, bheda bheda sakala mopi harihe, suddha bhaktim, Swadhyam tatpriti meva iti upadishati gaura chanda sayangsa. All nine things are there, evidence, and one is prameyo and nine praman. Nine evidence, praman, ultimately two nine praman going to establish prameyo. Only the difference here, maybe it is the arrangement of Krishna to make fighting. I don't know. Krishna always speaking, for me you will have to go there and steal some, you know, something. And Krishna speaking, some thief can come into your room, be careful. Krishna is this kind of clever. Sometimes giving instruction, you go and steal things. And giving instruction to whom, from whom, the whom, from where is going to steal. Hey, be careful, some thief coming very shortly. This is the system. Krishna always making this kind of system. So you see, though we know, by amnaya praha tatyam harimiha sarva saktim rasadim tad binnangsha angsha jivana prakritika valityana tad bimustangsha bhavat veda veda sakalam api harehe suddha bhaktim swadha tat pritimeva iti upadeshati Gaurachanda Swayam Sa. Swayam, Gaurachanda speaking. Nine evidence, and through nine evidence, we are going to get concrete Siddhanta that Krishna to be worshipped. Prameyo Ratnavali. And Ballabhidhavasan already writing so many things. If I go on discussing it a long time, actually, Ballabhidhavasan already writing Guru Parampara, everything. Actually, I can discuss this sloka during Gaur Purnima, Amanaya Prahatatyam, but now I like to draw some conclusion here because time is limited. Here actually, Vishnu, Madhvacharya purposely, and you know, our Guru Varga giving evidence, why it is written in Rasa Leela, why Vishnu this word, this is him. Rasa Leela, end sloka. End slope. Why Vishnu? Vikriritam vajabadu viridancha Vishnu. Sraddhan nitam manusrinamad athaparnayedija. Why Vishnu? Now question coming. I already give answer at the time of Bhagavad commentary. You can remember. Vishnu, this word here in place of Krishna written. Why? Because Krishna going to manifest himself in 100 crores Gopika. This is one kind of affluences. Follow? Vishnu is all pervading. Means Krishna is all pervading. Krishna is all pervading. That's why Vishnu is all pervading. So what wrong in it? If it is written in Rasa Leela, Vikritam Bhajavad Viridancha Vishnu, that doesn't mean here Vishnu means not Krishna. Doesn't mean. Krishna is written here because Vishnu, Krishna going to manifest himself is one kind of, first of all, to give you a right impression that be careful, this Rasa Leela is done by all powerful Supreme Lord Krishna. That's why he is, Vishnu means Bapak, endless power. To express this word, because Krishna is a sweet word, and Vishnu is a word giving some appearances, power. That's why, maybe Madhavacharya also very, very cleverly using it. Otherwise, why I can show you one by one? I can also show from the writings of Shankaracharya, how nice, sweet writing by Shankaracharya about Krishna Leela. How nice writing! You cannot believe. So sweet writing by Shankaracharya. Externally, you can say, is Mahabadi? But I can, one by you can show how nice Gopi, Ras, nice, then everything, all Leela there. How we can say that Shankaracharya is Mayavadi? You should believe, by the instruction of Krishna, Shankaraha, Sakyat Shankaraha, was bound to do this seva. By the instruction of Krishna. Otherwise, why Shankaracharya, after giving final touch of his final life, when body going on, going to leave body, when Shankaracharya finally what writing? Bhajo Govindam, Bhajo Murmate, Sangprapte Sannihite Kale, Nahi Rakshati Dunkriya Karane. Sanskrit grammar not going to save you. Be careful. Do bhajan. Bhajo Govindam, Bhajo. Why Shankaracharya is writing? Why? If he is Mahavadi, externally he is acting as Mahavadi. Internally, Bhakti. Bhajo Govindam. This way, maybe Madhavacharya, very in a tricky way, putting that Vishnu, all pervading Lord, is our Adidevata. We are going to worship. So, external, Vishnu is ultimate. To get the lotus feet of Vishnu, is our ultimate goal. Madhavacharya speaking, there is different kind of philosophy. Shankaracharya speaking, what kind of philosophy? Advaitavadi. Be careful. Shankaracharya is Advaitavadi. Ramanujacharya is Visishta Advaitavadi. Madhvacharya is Dvaitavadi. And Vishnu Swami and Nimbar. Dvaitavadi. Bhedabhedvadi. Bhedabhedvadi means Dvaitavadi. And Shuddha Dvaitavadi. Four. Different kind of philosophy. You can go mad. What kind of brain, what kind of bhakti you should have inside your heart, so you can catch everything, all point. You can go mad, Maharaj's brain. Not there. Bhakti should be there. So you see, now I have to give final touch. So actually, no time, otherwise I can discuss. So Madhavacharya is Dvaitavadi. Dvaitavadi, Madhavacharya want to speak that actually Vishnu is the all-pervading Lord. Madhavacharya confessed that Brahma is our Adi Guru. Madhavacharya confessed like same. What Mahaprabhu? What I told na? Just now I told na? Amnaya praha tatyam harimiya sarva saktim ras. Same thing. Almost same. Madhavacharya speaking, through Amnaya, Sauta Parampara, Veda, we can get right Siddhanta. All jivas can have two types of, one is Baddha, one is Mukta. Jivas can be free. Jivas can get freedom by getting bhakti, Vishnu bhakti. This way, all one by one I can. And this in this creation is not at all 100% false. Shat. This way, one by one, Siddhanta, if I discuss, you can understand. He is all right Siddhanta. What Mahaprabhu giving? Same Siddhanta we are giving from Madhvacharya. Why you are going to say that we are not in the line of Madhva Gauri Sampradaya? Why? Speaking this way? Almost same. Only the difference is there. Here, Madhvacharya speaking, our ultimate goal is Vishnu Charan. Through pure bhajan, you can get the lotus feet of Vishnu. This way, one by one, Madhvacharya is stopping all line in a prameyo, prameyo one, and pramano. Very nice, Siddhanta. So Madhavacharya is a great, you know, great lion actually. Madhavacharya among Madhavacharya, Ramanujacharya, all Acharyas, Madhavacharya is topmost. Why? Madhavacharya is the number one fighter of Mayavad, against Mayavad. Be careful, Ramanujacharya also big, but still, Madhvacharya is more. Madhvacharya is more. Madhvacharya is crass. Eradicate. Like to eradicate. Mayavad. Throw everything. By the mercy of Supreme Lord, today we have the chance to discuss about the holy Siddhantas and life and precepts of Madhvacharya. In short, I am very sorry, I couldn't complete so many things, endless things. I am very sorry to stop now here. Vāñca kalpa durva sikapa sindhubhya vajapati dānaṁ pāvana bho vishnabhya. Now,